we are going to discuss or we are going to learn addition of integers. So in previous classes you have learned how to add whole numbers and you know also the properties of whole numbers. So today we discuss addition of integers, first using a number line and second we will also learn without using a number line. Because for large numbers we cannot use the number line. So we have to also learn how to add integers without using a number line. So first let us start using a number line. So there will be three types of addition. One will be positive integer plus positive integer, then positive plus negative integer, then negative plus negative integer. So here we will have three types of addition of integer. First is positive with a positive integer, positive with a negative integer, negative with a negative integer. So let us start with positive with a positive integer. So I am drawing the number line. So you know what is a number line. So number line is a straight line which represents the numbers. So you mark one of the point as a zero. Then if you go to the right side of zero, you will find positive integers. And if you move to the left side of the zero, then you will find negative integers. So you mark the integers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So let it be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, like that. Okay, so the distance between two consecutive numbers is called the unit distance. So the distance between 0 to 1 is also equal to the distance between 3 to 4. Okay, so let us start the addition of positive with a positive integer. Let's take the example 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4. Okay, so 3 is a positive integer, 4 is also a positive integer. So how to find the sum of these two integers? So first step is you mark the first integer. So first integer is 3. So you mark it 3. Mark the integer 3. Mark the place or the point where 3 is there. Then second integer is plus 4. Okay. So second integer is also positive integer. So when the second integer is positive, so you have to move the right side of the first integer. Okay. So please see carefully, watch carefully. First integer is 3. So I have marked the 3, the place of 3 integer. Okay. Then the second integer is 4. That is also positive. Okay. So if the second integer is positive, then you have to move the right side of the first integer. So what is the second integer here? 4. So you have to move 4 jumps to the right side of 3. You see how I am going? 1, 2, 3, 4. So when did I reach? 7. So answer is 7. So 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. You also know that 3 plus 4 is 7. Okay. As it is, both are whole numbers also, are positive integers. So 3 plus 4 is 7. Let's take another example. suppose 2 cross 4. So first, you have to mark the first integer. So what is the first integer? 2. So where is 2? So this is 2. This is 2. Okay. Let us take 2 plus 6. 2 plus 6. So first, you mark the first integer. So I have marked 2. Okay. 2 integer on the number line. Then what is the second integer? That is 6. Okay. So is it positive or negative? Positive. So you have to move right side of the first integer. So how many jumps you have to make? 6 jumps. Very good. How many jumps? 6 jumps. Okay. So let us start from 2. You see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So where did I reach? Where did I reach? 8. So the answer is 2 plus 6 is equal to 8. Okay. So 2 plus 6 is equal to 8.